Whatever happened to the specialized store? A store that specialized in certain things, i.e. like guitar strings. A shop that specializes in CDs and your vinyl and stuff. A shop that specializes in your eggs and stuff like that there, your chicken shops. So you go into Halfords right now and I say to them, right, will this drive shaft fit my carburetor? They look at you as if you got two heads. And then they go outside, they pull the bonnet and have a look underneath. They may as well be looking up a frog's arse. Having a clue about yokes. Right, you go to a mechanic. Mechanic's reared on ratchets and gears and motors and engines and stuff like that there. You stick the engine on and she pours. He could tell by the pour whether she's ready to rack or she'll fill the MOT. But the same fella in Halfords, he'd be happy enough to sell you the 240 dice that you don't need. Car mats, suction cleaners, radios. You need a new radio with Wi-Fi, digital frequency. And all I want's the yoke to go by. You know, everything's merging to yeah by the superstore. You go in a Tesco and need to get everything. From cabbages to figs to bins to carrots to washing up fairy liquid. Video games, televisions, different opticians in the grocer. Have you ever heard the lack of it, boy? It's too big. It's too conglomerate, boy. And there's this whole big wave of plastic, boy. Plastic's a new buzzword. You can't use plastic bags. Which, fair enough, but I've tried to burn plastic many a time, boy. And it just got dirty old fumes comes off the back of our, boy. The poor wee animals must be thinking themselves, what in the name of buck have we done to the human race to deserve getting absolutely plastered in plastic? Turtles are getting straws up their noses. Dolphins are eating loads of plastic bags, by. The old smithick's rings around a fish's neck. It's strangled to death, by. And God love the wee creators. But please, do not turn the curly finger of the customer. So you go to the checkout with all your bits and pieces, by. And the wee fella behind the checkout, wee spotty fella whose voice hasn't broke yet, put scans all your stuff through. More plastic than you'll ever see in your life going through that till. And then he'll ask you, do you need any bags? Well, how else you ain't going to carry them, you fucking dope. Then he rolls his eyes at you. Oh, here we go. Here's an odd customer that didn't bring their bags with him. He's probably on commission for selling as little plastic bags as possible. Yet every product in that place is coated in the stuff. Plastered in plastic, by. What are you guilt-tripping me for? You know, where's your brown paper bags? The staff don't give a fuck because they're taught not to give a fuck. And that brings me back to my first point. Back to an era of the shopkeeper. An era where the staff genuinely cared about the customer. Back to an era where the term that doesn't exist anymore, customer service, was number one. Back to an era where you would go into a music shop and you could buy guitar strings and then bother away on a piano at the same time. Back to an era when you had a genuine relationship with the shopkeeper. The man that owned the store knew you by your first name. Knew every customer by their first name. Knew their needs. Knew their wants. Here's your bag of oranges. You didn't even have to ask them. You'd be coming in every week getting the same thing. And he knew what you wanted. What you needed. And it was an era where the butcher, the shoe cobbler, and the candlestick maker were hand in hand, in unison as one, together for us, the customer. And with every pound earned, that pound stayed in the town. And it didn't go away over to the FTSE 500 like it does with Tesco. It is awful handy, that Tesco, at the same time, isn't it?
Go for Taxi Joe!